Welcome everyone, my name is Kashyap and I am your English language teacher. I hope you all are doing well. This video is for grade 6, 7 and 8. So today's presentation is going to be about conjunctions and phrases and clauses. Make sure that your notebooks are with you so that you can copy down, as these notes will be very helpful for you in solving the worksheets that I'll be sharing in the end. So let's begin. What are conjunctions? Conjunctions are used to join clauses, phrases, and words together for constructing sentences. Conjunctions make a link between or among words or group of words to other parts of the sentence and show a relationship between or among them. For example, I'll be sharing few examples with you. Example number one. Alex and Robin are playing together. Here, and is conjunction. Alright, come to second one. Alex plays well, but Robin plays better than him. Here, but is the conjunction. Now come to third example, that is, I play cricket and Robin plays football. Here, and is conjunction. Example number four. When he was sick, I went to see him. Now let's just proceed to the types. There are three types of conjunction. Number one, coordinating conjunctions. Number two, correlative conjunctions. Number three, subordinating conjunctions. Now let's just start with the very first one, that is coordinating conjunctions. So the job of a coordinating conjunction is to join two words, phrases, or independent clauses which are parallel in structures, There are seven coordinating conjunctions, which are by far the most common conjunctions. And, but, for, nor, or, so, and yet. Following are the examples of coordinating conjunctions. Example number one, we went to the stadium and enjoyed the cricket match. Example number two, do you want an ice cream or chocolate? Example number three, go away and never come back. As you can see in the picture, the words that are underlined, those words are coordinating conjunctions. Alright, come to second type, that is correlative conjunctions. So what is a correlative conjunctions? A correlative conjunctions uses a set of words in a parallel sentence structure to show a contrast or to compare the equal parts of a sentence. The words of correlative conjunctions have a special connection between them. The correlative conjunctions are not only, but also either or neither, nor, both, and, not, but, whether, or. For example, I'll be sharing few examples with you of correlative conjunctions. Neither Alex nor Robin can play baseball. Example number two, I want both ice cream and. Example number three, he ate not only the ice cream but also the chocolate. Here, the words that are underlined, those are correlative conjunctions. Now come to third type, that is subordinating conjunctions. So what are subordinating conjunctions? A subordinating conjunction joins elements of an unparalleled sentence structure. These elements are usually dependent clause and an independent clause. Most commonly used subordinating conjunction are as follows. For example, after, how, then, when, although, if, that, where, as, in order that, though, which, as much as, in as much as, unless, while, because, provided, until, who, whom, before, since, what, whoever, whomever. So following are the examples of subordinating conjunctions. I'll use few of the words in my examples as well, so it will be more clearer to you all. Example number one, before we left home, I had my breakfast. Example number two, provided. Yeah. Example number one, before we left home, I had my breakfast. Example number two, provided they come, we can start class Tuesday. Example number three, when he was washing my car, I went to the store. Example number four, even though the weather was horrible, they still went outside. Here, the underlined words are subordinating conjunctions, as you can see in the picture. So these were the types of conjunctions. Now, following are the worksheet of types of conjunctions. I have shared few worksheets of conjunctions with you all. The first worksheet is about coordinating conjunctions. In that, what you have to do is, first of all, read the directions. It's written, complete the sentence with correct conjunction. Word bank is already given above, and below there are the sentences. Just read the sentence and put the appropriate one in the sentence. Okay, all right, I'll be solving the first one for you. The question is, complete the sentence with the correct conjunction. Number one, when we were young, dash, the world was younger too. So let's just see which one is the most appropriate one. When we were young and the world was younger too, but the world was younger too, or so, when we were young, so the world was younger too. I guess this is the most appropriate one. Now let's just proceed to our another worksheet, that is subordinating conjunctions. So in this worksheet, what you are going to do is you are going to combine each pair of a sentence using a conjunction from the word bank. Number one, the teacher let us listen to music. We worked on our papers. Here are the words given in the word bank. You just have to pick one and write in the middle of the sentence. Now let's come to third worksheet, that is related to correlative conjunctions. Complete each sentence with an appropriate correlative conjunctions given in parentheses. Number one, the cookies are dash homemade dash yummy. Options are already given to you. You just have to pick one and you have to just write, okay? The cookies are not only homemade but also yummy. Now the rest of the correlative conjunctions, you are going to do it all by yourself. So this was all about conjunctions and type of conjunctions. Our next topic is clause and phrase. Clause and phrase are two important terms in English grammar. Clause and phrase are parts of a sentence. A clause is a group of words that consists of a subject and a verb. For example, he laughed. Here, he is the subject and laugh is a verb. Example number two, the guests arrived. All right, now come to phrase. A phrase is a group of words that does not consist of a subject and a verb. Examples are on a table, under the tree, near the wall, on the roof, at the door. phrase does not consist of a subject and a verb. Both the clause and phrase may exist within a sentence. For instance, read the following sentence. He is sleeping on the bed. Now, as you can see in the picture, here clause and phrase are used in the sentence. The first part of the sentence, he is sleeping, is a clause because it has a subject and a verb. On the other hand, the remaining part of a sentence, on the bed, is a phrase because it lacks both the subject and the verb. Read the following examples. The underlying part of each sentence is a phrase. Non-underlying part of each sentence is a clause. Now, example number one. She is standing on the roof. Example number two. The cat is sleeping under the table. Example number three. She is drawing a map on the wall. Example number four. She is waiting at the door. Now, in these sentences, the underlying part is a phrase, and the part that is not underlined in of each sentence is a clause. Now you have to, now understanding the conceptual difference in clause and phrase. The reason of explaining phrase and clause to you is that it's used, the words phrase and clause is quite often used in conjunction. So now let's just get back to the topic. We were discussing about clause and phrase. So understanding the conceptual difference in clause and phrase. A clause has both subject and object. It can stand alone as a complete sentence because it gives a complete meaning. For instance, in the above example, the clause he is sleeping can alone stand as a sentence, as it gives a complete meaning to the reader, as you can see. On the other hand, a phrase cannot stand alone as a complete sentence because it does not give a complete meaning. For instance, in the above sentence, on the bed cannot stand as alone sentence as it does not give a complete meaning. The each word of phrase has a meaning, but the phrase collectively does not make a complete sense like a sentence. The purpose of phrase is to complement the overall structure of a sentence. A simple sentence can also be called one clause. For instance, he laughed is a sentence, but it is also one clause. Some sentence may have one, may have more than one clause. Read the following example. I waited for him, but he didn't come. Here, two clauses are used. I waited for him, and the another one is he didn't come. Now, example number two. I like biology, but my brother likes physics because he wants to become an engineer. Here, three clauses are used. I like biology is the first one. My brother likes physics, second one. And the third one, he wants to become an engineer. So these are three clauses that are used in just one sentence. I hope you all have understood. Still, you have any query, you can ask me down in the comment section that is given below, or in my online classes you can ask. I hope you all enjoyed. This presentation is clear to you all. Thank you so much, everyone. Allah Hafiz. Take care. Allah Hafiz. Take care.